good evening. Hope everyone's having a wonderful. I'm Gabe Cohen. I am one of the high school music teachers. I'm also the performing arts coordinator for the Concord School District. I just want to welcome you to our district choral concert. This is a wonderful evening. We're going to celebrate some choral music with all of our choral students from grades 6 through 12. Just so you know, we do structure these concerts so they're not super long. The expectation is that everyone gets to stay and watch each group as they get older. You can see the experience and skill get better and better. The chorus concert does a great job of making sure you stay, because I think everyone's singing in the last tune, so no one should be going home until we're done. Okay? Middle school students, I believe, I know that Mrs. Allard is really good at giving instructions and whatnot, but when you're not performing, you are sitting with your families. Please keep in mind that that's sitting with your families. That doesn't mean going up into the balcony by yourselves. You need to be with your families. In the past, we've had some students go up into the balcony, and it really inhibits the experience for the people who are sitting in the balcony. So please just stay with your families. In the event of emergency, there are some ushers around. They will be glad to help you out, but also please note where the emergency exits are. All of them take you right downstairs and outside, so in case of emergency, please follow those and the exit signs, but also the ushers that are there. Please do not use any flash photography tonight. It does make a big difference for our performers. It gets in their eyes, and then they get distracted, and it's not a good scene. I've seen it before. Also, please do not do any personal recording. I believe CCTV is here recording. That link should be out later this week. They do a fantastic job, and they do. You'll get to see your kids on video just by using that. Take a quick minute and thank the CCA. All the people that work here are great. They're always so accommodating. They make our day fantastic. The high school came down this afternoon and had a nice little dress rehearsal so they could experience their performance before they get to perform, so they're not as nervous. So thank you to all of the Capital Center people. I also want to just... Oh. We do greatly appreciate you paying the $5 fee coming in. That fee just pays for the part of the bill from the Capital Center that the school district does not cover. So it just gets turned around. We have to load U-Hauls. There's all kinds of costs associated with the concert, doing a concert here that's not at a school. So that's what that pays for. Thank you so much for paying that. Want to take a minute and thank FOPA, our parent group. Really, I want to thank Really, I want to thank Pam Wicks and Karen Ducharme. They do a fantastic job of organizing everything that FOPA does. So you know, there are some students around. They'll be around during the transitions. They are selling 50-50 raffle tickets. For those of you that don't know, FOPA is they're a really great organization. They do help us, but they also raise money for student scholarships. And last year we gave out 3 eighth grade scholarships for kids to take lessons over the summer. They pay for our drum majors to go to drum major camp. They pay for students to go to Sims and theater camp and all of these things. So the money raised during that 50-50 raffle is just turned right around, and it helps our students have an awesome experience in some other places other than Concord High School. So thank you, and now you don't have to hear me talk the rest of the night. I'm going to turn the concert over to the chorus teachers. Enjoy the show. Thank you.
Good evening. Thank you so much for coming out on this warm March evening. It's lovely to see you all again. As the sixth grade comes to the stage, just want to issue a couple reminders, one for myself so I don't forget later. The only soloist that will feature tonight will be in the seventh grade portion of the middle school concert. But if you can hold your applause when we have solos until the song is over, we would really appreciate that. The kids have a hard time when there's applause in the middle of a song, they can lose their place and they have a hard time keeping track of what they were doing. So if you can hold your applause till the song's over when there are solos, we would really appreciate it. Thank you. And then these two songs are, we're going to start with the Drinking Gourd, which is a traditional American map song. from the time of the Underground Railroad. It was spread by a man named Pegleg Joe, who was one of the conductors on the Underground Railroad and was giving directions of how to escape for people that were going to be meeting up with him. And so we'll start with that, and we'll be featuring a Concord High alumna musician, Miss Megan McNeil, on the flute. And then we will do cantamos, featuring some Spanish lyrics. We challenged each of our grades to try a song in a different language. So sixth grade chose Spanish this year. Should be a fun one.
That's what Bigfoot traveling on.
All right, as the seventh grade gets settled on the rise, and the sixth graders find their way back to their families, they're making their way. So as I mentioned, I challenge the middle schoolers to step out of their comfort zone for this concert every single year and try to pick something in a different language. It gives us an opportunity to explore choir technique in a different way. Singing in a different language forces you out of our regular speaking habits. Sometimes we're lazy talkers, and so learning how to sing in another language forces you to think about the way that you actually make sound. And so that's one of many reasons that we have done that theme for the middle school for the last few years. The seventh grade has chosen a Korean folk song this year called Doraji. It's about a wild mountain flower that is quite lovely and special in Korean culture. And they've had to practice a lot of good open vowels, which has been a challenge for our native English speakers here. And we will follow that with a song called Can You Hear, which will feature a whole bunch of people. So starting that song will be Katie Komorek, followed by Sophia Sargent, then Maddie Robert, Lydia Barrett, Izzy Jordan, Amelia Tibbetts, Miriam Darman, and Annabelle Prue. So you'll get to hear a whole bunch of different featured singers. So give a warm welcome to the seventh grade chorus.
Thank you.
So we roped in the wonderful Mr. Nathan Tarian, our orchestra teacher, to play bass with us. So thank you, Mr. Tarian. And you'll also hear some of our students shaking some shakers, as is appropriate for this style of music. And then we will finish with Wild Mountain Time, which is a Scottish folk song. A lot of people are very familiar with Irish folk songs that have been passed down over the years, Danny Boy, etc. But they don't often hear Scottish folk songs unless it's bagpipes and drums. But there are some lovely vocal Scottish music as well. So we'll finish with Wild Mountain Time and then turn it over to the high school. Thank you so much. This is the 8th grade chorus.
I'm not going. on the screens, that's from all the art students in the Concord School District, and it's also Arts and Our Schools Month, so we are celebrating them as well. We're going to start with the song True Colors. David Wicks is on the conga, which you can bring up. This song, I discovered, they all told me that it's in Trolls, but it was a song before that as well, so it's a cover of the original.
Thank you.
be, or new percussionists. They didn't know they were percussionists till my husband did this. So they're going to start setting up right now. You can set up over here. Our last piece is called Apple Tree, and it's a cover of a pop song. And I like it because it's a little weird, and it has a lot of percussion section, which is like my favorite two things. Like a little weird choir song is my favorite. But it also is just like, it's fun to sing, and whenever I sing it, or whenever I don't sing it, whenever they sing it, it reminds me of how awesome it is to sing all together in one space and enjoy music making. So I hope you enjoy. And then I think middle schoolers, you are getting lined up over here.
Yeah.
we've never rehearsed this all together, which is pretty cool. Ms. Batty, our awesome accompanist, has... Ms. Batty. She has recorded her playing on the piano, and we've all practiced with that. The Chamber Singers has gone down to the middle school, gone up to the middle school, and rehearsed with them once when we were first learning it. Period 7 choir went to the middle school and rehearsed with, I think, the 7th grade choir once. And that's all the practice we've had together. So it's kind of exciting because you're kind of getting to see, like, we're all going to experience it together. And it looks like we have spots, so this will be exciting.
Ready?
Thank you for being here tonight. A lot of fun.